Dear friends, this is Prithivi Raj from Bangalore connecting with you once again through this short message on God against false piety. In Matthew 6, 1-18, we read about the outward and inward expressions of piety. Jesus picked up three Jewish customs like almsgiving, prayer and fasting that were wrongly practiced by the Pharisees and taught valuable lessons to his disciples. The acts of righteousness were common in Judaism, and Jesus assumed that disciples were already practicing those acts. Alms were acts of charity and were sought by the unfortunates. Pharisees used to sound trumpets under the pretext of calling the poor, but inwardly they were seeking a vain glory for their charity. The public prayer was uttered at set times of the day. The devout Jews stopped wherever they were at the set time and recited the prayers in standing position. But the Pharisees used to position themselves in prayer where they can be easily noticeable by others, like in street corners. Their motive was not that God might accept them, but men might admire them for their piety. Fast in Jewish context meant going without food from sunrise to sunset. Fasting twice a week was considered as a sign of devotion. Jews used to disfigure their faces and put ashes on their heads during fasting as a sign of mourning. Jesus drew a contrast between his disciples and the hypocrites by instructing his followers to examine their motives. Jesus exposed the motives of pseudo-spiritual class and cautioned the disciples to guard their life against such hypocrisy. Jesus demands us to consider our motive of what we do and reminds us that if our motive is not of God, then not of God is what we will get. Jesus says, if our aim is to be hailed as spiritual and generous ones, or to gain recognition for what we do, we have already obtained what we have sought. Why do? What we do? The message in saying that not let our left hand know what our right hand does is to keep our good works and generous giving concealed as much as possible. We have to do good work because it is a good work, not because it would earn us a good name. Our motive in helping others and serving others has to be bringing glory to God. In 1 Corinthians 10:31, we read as, whatever you do, do it all for the glory of God. Jesus emphasized the importance of personal and private prayers. Prayers are not meant to show our piety. We are taught to avoid vain repetitions in prayers. Prayers said in secret are more effective and are pleasing in the sight of God. Secret prayer is the secret of effective prayer. Our prayer can be simple, but it has to be sincere. And this doesn't mean that Jesus dismissed the corporate prayer which is done publicly. Jesus rejected external displays during fasting. Jesus asked his disciples to apply oil to the head and to wash their faces, which was normally done for joyous occasions. The point is that we should not seek vain glory for our spiritual efforts and activities. We look at the outward acts, but God looks at our motives. Whatever we do on earth, is watched by our God, who is omniscient and omnipresent. We should be convinced that our God, who sees us in secret, will reward us publicly. The most important thing in our Christian life is not what happens to us externally, but what we become internally as we live in Christ. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, thank you very much for the teachings we received. Help us not to seek glory to ourselves in anything we do in your name. Enable us to keep our motives right always. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you for listening. God bless you.